It is May 29th as I'm recording this, a week and a half since Eula's been released, and since then I pulled 7 copies of her for C6. But she's still C0 with 6 Stella Fortunas, the constellation thingies, because I've been having an existential crisis about making this video. Hello YouTube frogs, and welcome back to another video that I wanted to record for a while on Eula. Is the interest for Eula lower now? Probably. Do I still want to make this video because it'll bother me if I don't? Yes. So I'm gonna do it! As you guys can tell from the intro, I've been going through a midlife crisis, keeping my Eula C0 for this video idea. Once this is complete, I can finally use my constellations to refine the broken pines for C6 R5 Eula. Let me know in the comments below if you'd like to see a showcase similar to my C6 Ganyu R5 Amo showcase. That's about it. Alright, let's go! Before we get into testing, I want to remind you guys that with the level 20 White Iron Greatsword that you see here, I'm also going to be using double cryo resonance and also a crit rate food only, no attack of food, in order to make my crit rate about 100%. This is so that testing is comparable to everything, right? If all of our hits crit, then we can see exactly to the total number of damage that we do. So I just want to make that clear, okay? Cool. Quick run through of my Eula again. She's still C0, same artifacts. So the stack damage will be identical. For all these showcases, I'll be using a neutral level 20 White Iron Greatsword so I don't overkill the Pyroritus Vine, which is our test subject. So what I wanted to cover in this Mastering Eula guide video is we're gonna go over rotations, combo rotations, also a new one that I found off of a YouTube comment, and discussing quickly attack speed, how it affects her, and constellations, if it changes her gameplay at all, and when her Q is off cooldown, what I think you should be doing in terms of team composition, etc. And yeah, well, let's get into it. A quick reminder to the terminology. Normal attack is N, right? These are the N1, N2, N3, N4, N5. That means N3 is 4 hits, N4 is 5 hits, and N5 is 7 hits. Tappy, holdy, no difference, all right? And then hold E stacks comes from the Grimheart stacks, 1, 2, and also 1 from the passive talent, this, okay? So that's a little bit of terminology. All right, so the current well-known combo for Eula is one of the two following. The first is an E, Q, WASD cancel, N4, hold E, N4, standard combo. This gives a standard 12 to 13 stacks. Now, you may be asking, what is WASD cancel? It is not dash canceling. It's simply tapping one of your directional keys during the Q animation to cancel the end lag and initiate your character to start walking. Further explanation, N4 grants 5 stacks. Hold E grants up to 4 stacks, but 1 overlaps with the next N4, so instead of 5 plus 4 plus 5, which is 14, we end up losing 1 stack because of overlap for 13 stacks. So that's the first standard combo. The next is a similar combo. We're looking at E, Q, WASD cancel, N4, hold E, delaying a little bit for the hold E to continue entirely, and then N4. In most cases, only the second N3 will connect, which is 4 hits instead of 5. N4 will be slightly too late. If you have perfect animation canceling, then you might be able to get 14, but it's pretty tough, and in actual combat, it's even more difficult. It's doable if you would like to master it, but I think its practicality is less than optimal. That combo is there, so I'm gonna leave it for you guys if you want to try it out. This combo is just finessing the previous combo, so the gain is minimal with lots of effort. That's the TLDR for it. Alright, so next combo is hold E first, then doing 2 sequences of N4 with dash cancel between. So we have E, Q, hold E, N4, dash, N3 to N4. Is a consistent 12, 13 stacks if you can connect the fourth one. This was the combo floating around before the standard became standard. So the standard is like the first combo that we showed. This one increases all of your normal damage because hold E is first, but has less Q damage. The overall damage is about the same. You can see off of the Pyroritus Vine's health that they're about the same. All right, so this last combo I would like to show you is a recent one I tested reading this YouTube comment. Shout out to Clockwork Anomaly providing the details on this combo. He says that if you do an in-depth combo guide, could you please test and mention the easier and consistent E hold Q E, E hold Q tap E N5 with 7 stacks. E hold, it applies the resistance buff before the Q crow hit. It's an easy combo without any events canceling. The energy meter disappear before Z2. The damage comparable applies 12 stacks consistently. So yes, you do lose 1 to 2 stacks, but your hits are all resistance shredded and you do more heavy hits. So it balances to less difference. Don't take my word, please test it out. And I did test it out. So I wanna amend this a little bit. So before we do this entire thing, we do tap E times 2, then E hold for the double stack, then Q, and then this combo, okay? So here it is. The showcase is, again, E times 2, hold E, then Q, then E, N5, which is the entire normal sequence. and then hold E at the very end. I just wait at the end. As you can see, this combo applies hold E for the Q to maximize your normal attack damage. And it also applies hold E at the end to maximize the Q damage. There's only one full auto sequence, N5, which grants 7 stacks. And this applies 2 E's in total during the Q, one right after the Q, and one at the very end before the Q pops, which is better for energy generation. All the previous combos typically only have one hold E during it. This combo also plays very well with the fast swap Eula nuke DPS because it requires Eula to set up 2 E's before beginning the hold E to Q combo. So what I mean by that is, since this is 4 seconds and you need 2 Grimheart stacks, you're gonna be swapping in her very quickly, tapping E and then switching out. So it molds better with the entire team comp because you're incentivized to keep swapping to her, which incentivizes team swapping. Right? So that's a good thing. I like this combo a lot. I think it plays exceptionally smoothly with a C0 Eula. It mitigates some of her recharge problems that I've explained in the guide video. So I'll probably start incorporating this combo into muscle memory and improving on it once I refine my pies, unlock more attack speed. And the great thing about it is it doesn't require any fancy canceling and actually utilizes her kit basically pretty efficiently. So that's an in-depth look at a few of her combos during her Q. As for outside of her Q, I think that's an opportunity for the other 3 party members to use their abilities to generate energy. Once they're done though, and she's back on the field without her Q, I would recommend a generic tap E, N5, tap E repeat combo. Looks like this. So tap E, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and your tap E's back. So this you can repeat in general because her full auto sequence is just around 4 seconds, which is her tap E cooldown that you just saw. But yeah, that's basically outside of her Q, but I would highly recommend you start swapping to other characters, right? Like if you have support Diana to generate energy, heal up your team, etc. I think that's a very good time when her Q is down. Next up, let's quickly go over her constellations and if they change her playstyle. I'm only going to be going over C1 and C2 because C4 is just a damage boost and C6 is just damage boost, right? It doesn't increase her attack speed by anything. So with constellation 1, you guys can see here that every time her E stacks are consumed, Eula's physical damage is increased by 30% for 6 seconds. Each stack consumed will increase the duration by 6 seconds up to maximum 18. So I'm not sure what happens if you hold E with 0 stacks. I'm not sure if you get it or not, but I'm just going to assume that you're going to have at least 1 stack before you hold E. I feel like that's kind of anti-intuitive to hold E with 0 stacks. I don't want to assume, but I'm going to effectively say that this is going to be for 12 seconds to 18 seconds, depending on how many stacks you consume. And for the damage bonus, the combos aren't really affected because since we're using the hold E when we have 2 stacks, during the duration of this C1 physical damage increase will almost always be 18 seconds. There's not really a worry. We're not changing any combos. So this is always the duration of her Q. So you never have to worry about it. Now moving on for her C2. I think this is a nice one to accommodate for energy recharge if you do manage to have C2. Dropping her hold E cooldown from 10 seconds to 4 seconds, which is basically what this does, allows her to begin fast swapping right after she ends the Q, which is very important because it increases her uptime by a noticeable amount. The combos don't change though, because most of the time you want to build 2 stacks of her Grimheart before doing a hold E. This just affects her outside recharge, which is actually pretty significant, right? So once you have your Q and it pops, you typically have a hold E right before it or during the beginning, and you can swap out to another character after your Q pops, do a couple abilities, and when you swap back to Eula with the C2 after you do a hold E, it should be up again. So it's pretty effective for fast swap, nuke DPS Eula. I think it's a very nice addition to her kit. So yeah, I mean, that's mostly the constellation. C4 is just generic damage, and C6, you know, is the potential for just maximizing Q. Cool. So that's constellation run through. All right, now, I never really touched upon attack speed in this video, and the main reason is because it takes so much attack speed to increase the Q stacks. By just 1 or 2 stacks. When I was testing, it took me 23% attack speed to increase my rotation to 14 stacks. On the screen, you can probably see that this is what it looked like when I was doing a rotation with 23% attack speed. I was still using the White Iron Greatsword. I used Chang Yun to increase the attack speed by 8%, and Jean's C2 to increase it by 15%, which is 23%. And the rotation was slightly different. It was an E, Q, N3, hold E, and then N5, and then explosion. So with these changes, what I'll probably end up doing is take the newest combo that we just discovered with Clockwork's Comet, with the E times 2, hold E, Q, tap E, N5, hold E, and then extend that. If you have more attack speed, you continue doing normal attacks there until the Q explodes. I think that is probably the best usage of attack speed when it comes to extending her combo. So I think that is the most efficient way not to make it too much of a headache, right? When it comes to attack speed, like, oh, do I have to change combos? No, I don't think you do. I think you should just extend the one that we talked about and it will be good to go. Because this makes it a less of a headache to min-max her stacks. It's more efficient to use because I think that rotation is a really efficient use of her passive talent and cooldowns. And I think that because it ends with the hold E, you can always just do autos after it. So that's what I think about attack speed. I think that mostly covers all my tips for mastering Eula. I wanted to give you guys a general combo overview, my suggestions for when her Q is down, which is basically just fast swap. I don't really recommend you auto, but if you have to auto, then you know to do E and 5E, and then how constellations affect her gameplay at all, which they don't really, and then attack speed, and if it improves her rotations, what I think you should just extend the most recent one that we discovered. So these are my current findings 1.5 weeks after Eula's released. It is May 29th currently. Eula was released May 18th, and I think it's finally time for me to enjoy her gameplay. These Stella Fortunas, probably on stream at twitch.tv/xlice, I'll probably be using them. They'll probably already be used by the time this video comes out. But yeah, I'll finally be able to C6R5 her now that I got this video out of the way. Thank you guys so much for watching, and if you made it to the end, I really appreciate if you like and subscribe for more content. And that's about it. We'll see you guys next time. We'll be right back.